What was?
I knew Nina Gold because she'd brought me in to do.
Oh,
Nina Gold is the casting director of Game of Thrones, and also the casting. I mean, she does Star Wars now, and I mean, amazing. But she is one of the greats, because I remember her coming to see me doing a tiny play in the old Red Lion in North London, and she'd do the legwork and she'd go and see people, and that was, you know, that's fantastic. It means that, you know, I mean, of course, Game of Thrones is they saw so many actors from the UK for that show, and I remember being given Lord Varys to read for my first screen test. And although they didn't think I was right for it, they thought I had potential, and then they went, oh, why don't you read this? So, you know, they kind of give out parts to see whether people fit them, and then kind of adjust according to, I mean, that's what happened to me anyway. But it was you know,
yeah.
doing that first lesson with Arya was the screen test that I had to do. And I did that like about 5 times, and eventually, most of the time you do the screen test and you forget about it, you know, because the chances that you'll get a recall or they will be interested in you, you know, is something you don't really dwell on too much. You just do the job and you kind of hope that, you know, they like it. But once you get, after you do the second time, and then the third time, and then the fourth time, and then by the fifth time when they say, oh, the Americans are coming over to meet you in person, that's when you really think, oh, this is now mine to lose, you know. So that was quite nerve-wracking, but, you know, it all worked out for the best.
Hi. How is everyone? My experience was very much like Miltos. I had an encounter, a screen test, and Robert Stern, the associate casting director for Nina Gold, had me read for Craster, and you can probably tell I'm not quite Craster. I'm not particularly confident when I come away from an interview. I tend to think I blew it. I came away from that interview thinking, oh, I have nailed this. And I got a call about an hour later, and sure enough, yeah, they loved you. You've not got the part. But come back in 2 weeks. And I came back and they handed me the 4 sides for Pyatt Pree. And absolute joy. And Robert, bless him, is not obviously Amelia Clarke, but reading in with Robert enabled me to do a very good screen test again. And luckily this time, I didn't walk out thinking I'd nailed it, but I had the part. Just again, that really good casting experience again from Nina and Robert, I think.
Robert Stern, her assistant, who reads in for the other parts when the actors come in to do their screen test, is so good at what he does. I mean, you imagine he had to read so
really,
many different
parts.
I will always say to this day that he helped me get that part because he read with me as Arya Stark so well. In fact, he was such a good actor that they gave him a part on the show. He plays the messenger in the first season in King's Landing. So.
I got the part by
osmosis.
Almost. And you go no further. I read for 3 separate parts. Well, we didn't read, we had to learn, didn't we?
Mm.
Learning those speeches. 1, 2, 3, didn't get them. Okay, and then someone who was cast got terribly, terribly ill, like to die, so they cast me. And I can tell you happily that he didn't die, and he later on got a part in the series called Roy de Trees.
Oh, right.
Yeah, and so I feel all right about it now. Dead Men's Shoes is something which happens so often in our business. Old people die and other old people who aren't dead.
step into the